Hello, this is Kimberly at Singing for Your Soul. Let's talk about breathing and the diaphragm. I have a lot of clients come in and ask me what diaphragmatic breathing is. How do I breathe from my diaphragm? How do I sing from my diaphragm? And I'd like to try to help clear that up because there is a lot of confusion, and deservedly so, around the diaphragm and what it means to breathe diaphragmatically. So let's start with what the diaphragm is. The diaphragm is a muscle, and it's located right about here, mid-torso, and it is kind of this little, I think of it like a little jellyfish shape, hanging down like this in its relaxed position. And when it descends, it flattens out, and it's more in the shape of like a pancake, because the diaphragm connects at the front and goes all the way around to the back. Okay, it's circular around your entire torso, and it basically divides the upper lungs, rib cage, heart, from the lower part of the torso where, you know, you have the stomach and the intestines and the kidneys, all the internal viscera down below. So the role of the diaphragm in breathing is pretty important and pretty basic. When the diaphragm contracts, it lowers, flattens out like a pancake, and that creates a lesser pressure. It lowers the air pressure in your lungs and your upper torso. And the thing about air is that it likes to flow from areas of greater pressure to areas of lesser pressure. So when you have lesser pressure, air comes in a sort of vacuum-like motion. So the diaphragm is responsible for helping to create that negative type pressure in your lungs. And once it's contracted down and the air has come in, then the diaphragm simply relaxes on the exhale and moves back to its dome shape. Now, the lungs need the assistance of both the diaphragm and the intercostal muscles, which are the muscles that are in between the rib cage. The lungs need their assistance for breathing. The lungs are organs and they expand, but they're not muscles, so they can't help the body to expand when they fill up with air. So the action of the diaphragm creating that negative pressure, and also the action of the intercostal muscles. There are intercostal muscles that help to open up the rib cage on the expansion, and then there are intercostal muscles that help to close the rib cage on the exhale. Okay? So the diaphragm and those intercostal muscles are working in tandem to assist the lungs in the breathing process. The breathing process is complex. It's very intricate, and even the most knowledgeable of the scientific, medical, and vocal communities are still finding out things all the time about breathing. So don't worry if you're confused. One of my favorite quotes that I heard is that if you're not confused, you're not learning anything. So confusion is not a bad sign. It just means that you're going to be asking some really good questions that will help you to become less confused as you figure things out. So the diaphragm is a puzzling piece of the breathing process, but this much we know is what I've already told you, that it contracts on the inhale and it relaxes on the exhale. So I really hope that's helpful, and we will go more in depth and introduce some wonderful breathing exercises in future videos so that we can really round out this series on breathing and clarify a lot for you. So if you like this info and you find it helpful and you want more, please go ahead and subscribe to our YouTube channel and like us on Facebook. Peace out. Mwah.